Hello everyone, this is Yopi the Yellow and I'm in the colony as you see, and today we're going to build a windmill. But I hear you ask, weren't you going to re-prank Golfhouse because of what he did to your house? Well, yes, but well, let's get into that later. The windmill is going to be right here on this little hill over here, which I have to make bigger. Well, you see, this is where I made a couple of wheat fields, because that's what I need for the windmill. But behind here, I'll show you, here's my new little sheep pen, because to prank Golfhouse I need a lot of different colored wool. I've got a couple of extra black ones for the roads for Mr. Picklesworth. But, oh, I have to, looks like I have to go to sleep soon. To prank Golfhouse, I need wool. And I need pumpkins and wood, a lot of signs and a couple of fences. And, well, I'm going to shear the sheep and build, and then shear the sheep and build, and harvest some pumpkins and build some more. So, after I've finished my windmill, I can start pranking Golfhouse. So, let's take a quick little nap. Up, open and close. Let's take a quick little nap and tomorrow we're gonna build. And good morning! This is where we're going to build the windmill. Let's make a little pillar so we can have a good look. Okay, that's where it's gonna be, because it's gonna have to catch the wind from the sea. And, well, that hill isn't really pretty enough, so before and after. Look, that's a nice round artificial hill. Well, any windmill in the Netherlands that's on a hill is on an artificial hill, because, well, there are hardly any non-artificial hills in the Netherlands. So, okay, after I did that, I went looking for pictures. I just googled windmill in Dutch and I collected a number of pictures for inspiration. I'll show them to you, they're gorgeous. But I wasn't looking for the prettiest windmill. I was looking for the one that really said windmill to me, the most iconic windmill. So these are the ones I found, and then I started to sketch. And this is my first sketch, but this one's just way too small. It's only 4 blocks wide, so no, not possible. Next one, that didn't really work either. I wasn't sure. It just looks a little bit like a penis with the cap and the round, well, windmill has to be round, so I tried this one, but well, Minecraft, I really can't get the gentle slope that I want, so look here, if I want to make the arms of the windmill connect with fences, the at the top the fences will connect to the wool blocks in a way that I don't really want. So, next sketch, this one. Looks better, doesn't it? The top part will be made of blocks of wheat, hay bales, and the bottom of nether brick. I kind of like this one. So, let's start building. Right, time to build. This is the center. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What was the circumference of my circle? Because, well, I googled Minecraft circles and it was 11. So let's try again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3. And well, you know how to make circles. Let's fast forward this. 5 and 2 diagonal. that's simple. That wasn't hard at all. Did I do this correctly? Oh, look. My wheat is growing very well. I need to harvest that soon, because I'm going to need a lot of bales of hay. And I'm going to have to shear my sheep again. And harvest some pumpkins. Well, I'll show you my progress later. And here I am on my little pillar, and there it is. I already made the walkway, so let me show you the windmill from up close. Come on, let's hurry, I want to show you. Want you to have a good look. Oh, and over here? Yes, right. It's gonna look good in the landscape, and it's going to be quite tall, but not as tall as a lighthouse. It won't touch the clouds. Yep, there I'm back. I'm back with several stacks of bales of hay. Come on, can't even get up a ladder. So, 3. That's not good. So I can't. Darn, looks like the walkway is too narrow. when you make sketches beforehand, this isn't supposed to happen. I have to take that one out too. Darn. This is not. Not happy about this. Also, this is where I come up, get up. I don't like to be able. I can see the binding of the wheat bales. I don't want a stripy windmill. I'm going to have to take this out. Maybe put in some. Well, take it out first. Right. This could work, so I can position the wheat bales against the dirt. Yeah. Okay, I'll show you when it's done. Okay. Yes, that looks better. There's going to be a lot of. This is my entrance. And this is. Yeah. Okay. And well, there has. Yes, it will be some binding will be visible from the side. Well, right. Yep. Okay, I'll show you when I've got more, because this part of the windmill is going to be 10 blocks high. Hello everyone, I'm back, and this is just. Doesn't it look too low to you? It doesn't look tall enough. Well, it didn't look tall enough to me either, and I didn't quite know what I did wrong, so I went exploring. And I got a lot of tulips, because, well, why not pull out all the stops and go for full cliché mode? But, eventually I found out what I did wrong. Look. This is my sketch. Wait, I'll go up a little. That's my sketch, my first sketch. And look at the bottom. I thought I made it 11 wide, and, well, you know, 5 plus 5 plus 1, 11 wide. No, this is not the correct way to count to 11. So I made my windmill too big, but that's not bad actually. That's not bad. I can make it even bigger, so I can make the walkway even wider, and it will still look proportional. So here's my other sketch. There, look. Yeah, that one is 11 wide and has a 3 wide walkway over there, and I can do the supports for the walkway now, because they're big enough. I think I'll take version A, and also it will It means that I have to make my the arms of the windmill like, well, 11 high instead of 9. And I've got room for a couple of windows. But I can't, over here, I can't make the cap, the top of the windmill, the part that has to turn with the arms of the windmill to catch the wind. I can't make that have an overhang, because that will make that just will make the windmill look too much like a penis. No giggling in the back, it's a medical term. Maybe that should be my the title of the video. Does not look like a penis. Yes, okay. Before and after. Well, it's high enough. Maybe I'll make it just one block higher. But oh no, I can't make it much higher, because the tallest arm of the windmill will stick out over that even more. I'm not really happy about those supports down there. I'm going to fiddle with that for a little bit. And after again. This is better. Not exactly what I want. I might change it. Still a little busy. But much better. Okay, now time for the cap. I made a sketch. Let's see if I can build it as I drew it. Well, this is the cap of the windmill. And as you see, it's kind of a complicated structure. Look at my sketch here. Actually, structures like these, how to build them, that will have to be its own a whole episode of itself. But look, this is my sketch, and from the front it's a simple half dome, and from the side it's very steep, and then it slopes to a 45 degree angle. And as you all know, the base was round. So what you do when you make a structure like this is, first you make the base, the simple part, and then you make one line from the side to the side through the middle. That's how you sketched it from the front. And then you make the other line from the middle to the middle, from the middle of the front to the middle of the to the center of the back. And you build that the way you did the sketch from the side. And afterwards you kind of sort of wing it when you fill in the quarters that are left over. As I said, this sort of thing needs an episode of its own. And there it is, my beautiful, beautiful windmill, almost finished, and with the cap on it doesn't look like a body part at all. So, yay for me. I've been harvesting some pumpkins for Golf House later. This is taking a long time and I still haven't re-pranked Golf House, but they say revenge is a dish best served cold. Well, ice cold in this case. Like ice cream. That sounds about right. Let's go do the arms of the windmill. That shouldn't be too hard. Okay, this might not be the smartest way to make these arms. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and jump. Okay. Oh, do not, you're glitching. Shift forward. Come on. Something's wrong. Uh-oh. Shift. Forward. Side. Okay. What happened? I'm logging out and back in for a moment. And we're back, and I'm still glitching. I think I'm going to have to break this to get... Okay. Right. Look at that, how pretty how pretty it is up here when it's snowing. And hop. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Did I want it that like this? 11, yes. And do mobs spawn on snow? Good question. I'll leave it like, if they don't, I can, if mobs don't spawn on snow, I can leave it like this. Top, yes. And okay, fun fact about windmills. If you find a windmill in the center of a village, there's a good chance that there's also a pet shop nearby. Well, you know, that's because, well, when people stopped getting their wheat milled, or not a wheat, their whatever milled locally, the millers needed another source of income, and a lot of them started to sell birdseed to supplement their income. And, well, that expanded into pets and pet supplies. And hop. So, if you're ever in the Netherlands, or if you live here, just take a look. It's windmills, quite close to a pet shop. There's one right next, a pet shop, right next to the windmill of my village. I'll post a picture one of these days. And 4, yes. I'm not putting a pet shop near this windmill. This one is for those wheat fields down there. And there it is, my wonderful windmill, if I say so myself. As you see, I've put in a couple of windows. I didn't think about it, I just knocked a couple of holes in the side. And I've moved the road over a couple of blocks so it could go right past the windmill at this side. There's one more thing I have to do before this windmill is ready, and that's okay. Look at this picture. See those poles on the back of the windmill? They are for the miller to push the windmill on the side. To make the cap rotate so it will fit the, so it will catch the wind. And I'll go up. I thought I had an overhang at the back. Did I take that away? Oh, I'm not at the back. Silly. Here it is. I'm just winging it, guys. This is not in my sketch, but I don't have much time. I want to finish this. Come on, come on. And yep. I want to finish this so I can... Oops! That wasn't smart. So I can go prank golf house, because it's high time. Okay, now I need a wheel down here, and it's like this, because this will go okay. How do I make a round wheel? Oh, wrong, because the other wheel in the picture is rather large, and this and that. And now I have to, and up. Oh, wrong. This looks kind of round, doesn't it, if I put a... Yeah. This is round. And a... Okay, I have two buttons. One button here. And... Oops, I have to get up for... Come on. So I can get... I want to get on here. Right. And then this... Oh. Hmm. Something's wrong. This is not correct. This would be the center of the wheel. I'm not sure about this. I'm going to have to take a look from a distance. That's too big, isn't it? No, that needs to be a smaller wheel. But if I make one out of two upside, well, four, two upside down stairs and two upside up stairs, that won't, then I won't be able to center it. Well, unfortunately, that's gonna have to be a teeny tiny wheel. And door. Right, I want to be able to pass this, because I want to be able to use this windmill as a watchtower so I can shoot creepers from here. There are so many mobs that spawn over there. You know, while I was googling windmills, I learned so much. I learned that a number of windmills were bombed in the Second World War by the Allied forces because they were afraid that the Germans would use the windmills as watchtowers. It wasn't a good time to be a windmill. Come here. I also learned that the resistance used windmills to come on up to send each other messages using the arms of the windmills as semaphores, but that might not be true because I couldn't find many details. You know, could I maybe add a couple of poles that are a little more from the side? I'm gonna try that. Oh yes, that's nice. You know, normally I would make a drawing and see how it looked from there, but I'm just winging it this time. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then one across, then three, and then one across. Okay. Now I make another one at this side, and then I'll be done. Yes, that's it. That's symmetrical. Very well. Time to shear a couple of sheep. Well, goodbye, everyone. That's it for this episode. I hope it was entertaining. See you next episode. Bye-bye.